So the way to understand why we're in such a mess now is to look at two historically unusual periods. So the first is the late 20th century. It's very hard to have a large, diverse secular society, a theocracy you can hold together, you know, an ethnic group you can hold together, but a large, diverse secular society is very hard. And you have to look at the forces pulling us in, the centripetal forces, and the forces pulling us out, the centrifugal. So World War II is the most powerful, you know, a war, a foreign attack, Pearl Harbor is the best possible way to bring people intensely together. And that whole generation who remembers World War II, they were great citizens, social capitalists for the rest of the century. And the news media had its period of enormous professionalism in the late 20th century. Before the 1920s, it was all terrible. And now in the 21st century, it's getting all terrible. Not all, but it's getting worse. So the late 20th century is really unusual in having binding forces and cohesion and common norms and a news media that we all watch the same three or four stations. So that was a really unusual period in having us be less polarized. And then everything changes beginning in 2000. There's a wonderful book by Martin Gurry called The Revolt of the Publics. And he talks about how information used to actually be something we sought out. I don't know if you remember those times, but it used to be that you had to actually reach out to try to find things. Now we're all hit by a fire hose of information. Most of all, you know, it's almost all free. And we're just trying to like not drown. And so that changed everything. And then that fire hose of information becomes really toxic between 2009 and 2012. People don't understand how much social media changed in those years. It wasn't polarizing before 2009. And we thought that it might even be good for democracy. But once Facebook introduced the like button, Twitter introduced the retweet button, and they algorithmicized everything based on engagement data, by 2012, we'd created this gigantic outrage platform. And the public square, public debates were incredibly nasty. And since 2015, 2016, that nastiness has crept into almost every major institution.